Hi and welcome back to Felicious Reviews, a channel where we talk about all things beauty, which includes makeup, skincare, and sometimes haircare and nails. So if you're interested in any of those, subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I post, which is Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Today we're talking about the Inkeyless Succinic Acid Acne Treatment. It's a new acne treatment from the Inkeyless, which is going to give you spot correction for your pimples as well as your blemishes. And I've been trying it for a while now, and I'll be giving you my first impressions. So if you follow through right now, if you keep watching, you're gonna see my first impressions. And then my review is going to be days later to show you how this product has performed. So you can jump right ahead to that review portion, or you can keep watching to see my first impressions. So my face is cleansed. I cleansed with water, and then I went ahead with my hyaluronic acid toner from Haru Haru, and then I used the 111 Skin, the rose gold sheet mask, and now I'm ready to go in with the Inkeyless Succinic Acid Acne Treatment. I do have this one pimple over here, which was really bad before, but it's a little better now that I've used a pimple patch from COSRX. And I'm going to put one dot over here and then one on some of my blemishes, because it does say that it's going to help blemishes as well. So I've been storing it in my skincare fridge from Kaluli. And this is my first application. I'm just going to take my clean finger and gently dab it all in. I haven't used a moisturizer yet, because this is supposed to be the treatment part of your skincare, which comes before moisturizing, apparently. And I'm not going to use a pimple patch on top of this pimple because I want to see how this treatment performs. And I'm going to be using it for the next 4 weeks to see if there's a change at all in the intensity of my blemishes as well as my pimple. Does it reduce in size? What happens with it? And the next part of this video is actually going to be after my 4 weeks, and I'm going to give you my whole review, a bit about this product as well. This part is basically just first impressions of this product, and my first impression is that it's nice because it doesn't feel like drying or anything. It doesn't smell bad either. So it's nice, it's okay. You can use it in your skin fridge if you want. It's not going to harden up or dry up. I like to keep it in the fridge because it has a nice cooling feeling afterwards. So that is basically it. I do like that it has gone to an invisible kind of finish, so I can use my moisturizer and stuff on top of my skin. It wouldn't have been ideal if, you know, you would have like patches of green pigment on your skin. But this is fine. This looks nice. The next part is going to be after my 4 weeks and my whole journey with this product. The last time I sat down here to talk about the Succinic Acid Acne Treatment, I did my first impressions and I showed you how I applied it and where I applied it. I also gave you a good look at what my skin looked like at that time, and it has officially been around 4 weeks since I started using it. Now, before I talk about how often I've been using it and the directions and everything, let's talk about what this product is going to do for us, what it claims to do, and what its ingredients are. The Inkeyless describes this as a gentle, non-drying acne treatment, which can be used for target correction or target treatment for your pimples, which kind of sounds ideal because sometimes you don't have a cluster of pimples around on your face. You do have one or two zits that are bothering you and you do want to get rid of those. So this is non-drying, meaning that it's not going to dry to a cement-like finish that a lot of acne treatments are, and it aims to clear acne spots fast, which means it's going to clear up the blemishes that you get from acne, which I do all the time. I have pimple scars so often that I really do need a product that addresses that, or that kind of reduces that. So now the next question is, how does this do that? It does this by three of its main ingredients, which is, first of all, succinic acid, which says on top, which is what it is primarily named after. And this succinic acid is used to absorb excess oil and visibly reduce the size of your blemishes. Now that is important and key word over here, which we're going to address in the review portion, so pay attention to that. And then it also has sulfur powder, which is also going to absorb excess oil and clears the pores in a long-term way. And then they have salicylic acid, which is a BHA, a beta hydroxy acid, which actually is something that a lot of acne products have, or exfoliating products have. So this is going to exfoliate your skin and also clean your pores. It's also a key ingredient in a lot of exfoliating treatments, exfoliating toners and serums. And I would prefer salicylic acid over a physical exfoliant like a scrub or something. So I like having that there. Now, when I applied it a while ago, in the video a while ago, but 4 weeks ago, that's when I was filming it, it came out green. And that is because it has a pigment in it that's called chlorophyll that you find in plants, that gives plants their green color. So, and Inculus also discloses that they have, since they are using chlorophyll, the color of the shade of the green in here may vary. It may not be a very strong green, or you know, a particular shade of green. So if yours doesn't look as green as maybe pictures on social media or something, then you don't need to worry about it. It's just a pigment. It's not really doing anything on its own. It's just a pigment. It's just the coloration, and it depends on how pigmented or how strong the chlorophyll that they're making the product with is at the time. That's my personal opinion. I think the green color in here is just for looks, it's just for visuals. It's not really doing anything because they don't really mention what chlorophyll is doing for your blemishes or your pores. But maybe it can be because blemishes usually are reddish in color, and a green pigment cancels out red pigment. So that might be the reason, which is kind of clever to have in an acne treatment. But more on that a little later. And it is supposed to be used every day, up to 3 times a day, before your moisturizer, but after your toner or serum, basically. This is the treatment part. So if you are wearing serums or toners, this should be the next step after your serum, in my opinion, because since it's kind of like a creamy product, I would suggest that you do it right before your moisturizer and right after your serums or toners or essences or whatever it is that you would be using. And I have been actually using it for 4 weeks, because I already told you, but I've been using it every single day for up to anywhere from 2 to 3 times a day. And I've been using it like right before my moisturizer, or if I sometimes forget, I would use it on top of my very thin moisturizer, which is the Summer Fridays Cloud Dew moisturizer. Now that we have talked about this product and what it can do for us, let's talk about my likes and dislikes about this product, because I have seen a change in my skin over the past few weeks, and whether it's a good change or a bad change, we'll get to know in a little while. So, review portion starts now. First of all, I really like that it has hydrating ingredients. So it's not literally a drying product. It's not drying or shrinking your pimples. It is hydrating them, which is what pimples need. Now, it's commonly mistaken to believe that pimples need to be dried out or to be left in the sun, or have or that you have to be really harsh with your pimples, like popping them or something, but that is the worst thing that you can do. What the best thing for you to do is to hydrate it and make sure that it is properly nurtured in a way so that it goes away on its own without leaving a mark. So if you scratch it, pop it, leave it out to dry in the sun, or you know, put on a lot of scrubs on it or something very harsh on it, it is not going to go away that easily, and it is definitely going to leave a mark. And I know, because I have done all of these mistakes in the past, and the marks of which are quite clearly on my skin. But my point is that I like that this is following the correct ideology behind it. Number two, I like how compact it is. It is very travel friendly. So this is like, it fits in your palm. It's like, if you compare it, this is how big it is. So it's absolutely travel friendly. Number three, I like that it is literally non-drying. Now, when I say non-drying, I don't mean in the chemical sense. I mean in the physical sense, which is that it doesn't dry hard on your skin like a lot of acne treatments do. So around like October, November, and basically whenever seasons are changing, my skin acts up and it will get a pimple that is going to take forever to go away, and it's going to leave a mark that is going to stay there for like months. So I have tried a lot of acne treatments in the past, including some from Clean and Clear, as well as from Maria Badescu, which was quite on the rise a few years ago, the drying lotion, the one that's a bottle-like packaging, and it's this big, and it's pink, and there's this solution on top. You have to shake it, and then you have to use a cotton swab to apply it, and then it dries down to a cement-like finish. And when I say cement-like finish, I mean cement-like finish. It feels super hard on your skin. So hard that if your skin moves a bit too much, it's going to, you can see some little cracks on that pink spot, and that is super ugly. And not just ugly, but it is super hard to wash off, even though there are supposed to be wash off, leave on, and then wash off treatments. But when it dries down to that hard of a finish, it is really hard to take off, and then you have to end up like scrubbing that area even more, making your pimple be more agitated and kind of inducing more damage than if you would have just left it on its own. So that is one of the main reasons that I have stopped using, that I had stopped using any acne treatments for my pimples, my breakouts, or anything, because they would all just end up making the problem even bigger. So when I read that this is non-drying, I was like, you know what, I'm going to try this out, because I do get pimples a lot. It is very comfortable to wear on your skin. It is not going to give you a lot of trouble. Number four, I really like that it is not a smelly product. Now, when I say smelly product, it's because I have tried products that really smelled bad and strongly bad, you know what I mean? So like the drying lotion from Maria Badescu, it would leave a very pungent, very acidic smell on my skin as long as it was on. And it was like, it was really, really strong. And that's not pleasant. I mean, you don't want your face to smell bad. You don't want your face, or basically you don't want yourself to smell bad, because like, that's icky. It has really no smell to it at all, and I can kind of endure it in that way. Number five, I really like the precision that I can get from this, because it has this needle nose kind of nozzle, or whatever you want to call it. It gives you very precise application. Number six, I love that it has an invisible finish. So it's not going to leave that green pigment on your skin all day long. You can blend it out, and it is just going to look like you have nothing on your skin, which is amazing, because again, as a lot of acne treatments go, they will leave a pigment, like either a white or a blue, or in case of Maria Badescu drying lotion, a pink residue or pink covering on the skin, which is okay if you're like home all day, but if you have errands to do, or if you're you know, going out or something, you don't want to have that patch of blue, white, or pink on your face like that, you know. Those can't be layered under makeup either, because you know, you're going to disturb whatever treatment that it's doing. And this can be layered under makeup because it goes to an invisible like finish. It's going to blend out like a moisturizer would, basically, but with green pigment in it, if that makes any sense. Number seven, I really like how you don't need a lot with this product. So a teeny tiny amount is going to be enough to cover a pimple like this big. So you don't have to, you know, take out more product, because this tiny amount is going to be more than enough. And I think you must have seen that when I was applying it on camera as well. You must have seen that a tiny product was enough to blend out over all of the tiny blemishes that I had. So that's pretty cool. Number 8, I really like that it kind of color corrects. Like I mentioned before, this is a green pigment and your blemishes and pimples are usually more reddish in color. Then green is going to cancel out red. So it temporarily gives you that blurred or that color corrected appearance, which I feel is so clever to have in an acne treatment. And I don't know why other brands have not thought of that before, because you know, when you're using an acne treatment, you would want to conceal your acne as much as possible. Like you would want to make it look like they're not even there. Obviously, it's not going to completely color correct, but it does so to a certain extent. Like you don't even have to wear makeup for it to look like it's reduced the pigment of your blemishes or your pimples, basically. Number 9, I really like that it truly has reduced the size of my pimples. Like I mentioned before, I had a really huge pimple right around over here, and I've been using this for the past 4 weeks, and I did not use a pimple patch ever since I started using this. I have not worn a pimple patch at all, and it went away on its own so easily and quite quickly. I was so amazed because I did not expect it to do much. I kind of thought it would be more like a gimmick than an actually good performing product, but it really does reduce the size of your pimples. So if you are somebody who gets a lot of pimples and quite often, or acne prone or something, then this might help you in reducing those pimples. And those are basically all of my likes. Now let's talk about my dislikes. Okay, so my first dislike with this product is that it has unclear instructions. Now when I say unclear instructions, I mean that it doesn't really tell you how you are supposed to apply it. Now I know it's not rocket science to apply it, but I mean, let me show you what I mean. Okay, so I mean you either do this, which kind of like completely blend it out onto your skin, or you tap it a few times and make it look like this. So I don't know whether I'm supposed to make it look like it's invisible or like it's supposed to stay there for like a while. So that's my problem with it, that it's not really that informative when it comes to how to use it, because not a lot of people are well versed with skincare and how we're supposed to apply it. And next dislike I have is that it gives you very unclear expectations. Now it does say that it is going to clear acne spots fast, but what is fast? Like what is fast? How are you measuring that time? It doesn't give you a time period of when you're supposed to be seeing any kind of results. Is it like fast, as fast as a day, as fast as a week, as fast as a, like 4 months? Like what is it, you know? So when brands come out with products that are supposed to change your skin in a certain way, like for example, if they come up with an hydrating serum, they're gonna say it's gonna do that, you know, whatever after the first application or after a 1 week of constant use or whatever. But this doesn't tell you how long you need to keep using it to see tangible results. So it doesn't tell you, it does tell you that it's gonna do it fast, but how fast is it, and who's measuring this amount of fast? Fast is very subjective. Fast for me would be maybe in a week. Fast for somebody else would be in a few days. So what is fast? And this is what was wrong with their fulvic acid brightening cleanser as well. They don't tell you how long you need to keep using it to see a brightness or a radiance in your skin. But the same thing is the problem with this product. Even in their promotional pictures, the ones they have on their website as well as the ones they have on Sephora, they show like a woman's like pimple acne area basically, and a before and after, and there's very slight difference in the before and between the before and after in the appearance of her pimples. But it still doesn't tell us, it still doesn't tell us how long is this after picture been taken. Is it like instantly, or is it a week after the application? Like, what is going on? So that's very unclear. So you're kind of, it just keeps you guessing basically. So if you're noticing a change, great for you. If not, then keep using it because it's gonna do it fast. So that is why I gave it 4 weeks, because I think that skincare is supposed to take at least a month before it shows you any tangible results. Of course, it differs with what kind of skincare product it is. Like, retinol is gonna take probably a lot longer, maybe 3 months to 6 months, but the average for all other products basically is around one month. Number three, I do not like that it did not help my blemishes. I still have the same kind of blemishes that I did before. I do not see a change in the blemishes. And this was the pimple that I had before, and it has left a mark. I did not scratch it, I did not pop it, nothing happened, just this product, and I still have a mark here. So, and I've still been using this on the mark as well, but it hasn't changed in its size, in its appearance. It only temporarily fades because of the color correction that happens in here because of the green pigment. But other than that, if I'm not wearing it, right after I wash my face and I'm not wearing it, it doesn't seem like there was any change in the size, in the appearance of my blemishes. It doesn't really do anything for your blemishes. Yeah. Number four, this product has given me quite some irritation. And when I say irritation, I mean it has literally given me new pimples, like this one. This wasn't here if you look back in to this video, like for my first impressions. I did not have this spot, this pimple, but I do now. I haven't been doing anything different to my skin that it's going to make it react that way. It's just happening like that, and I feel like I'm getting more of these blemishes that I didn't before. I feel like there's this new kind of cluster of tiny little blemishes happening all over my skin, like over here and then over here, because those were where I was applying this. I didn't apply anywhere else on my skin, which is why my other parts of my skin is completely fine. And this is one of the complaints that I saw from a lot of people who use this, that it gives them a lot more irritation, a lot more of redness, a lot more of pimples popping here and there. So if your skin is sensitive, mine is not that sensitive. Like, my skin basically tolerates a lot that I throw at it, so it doesn't really react a lot on. But this really did not suit well with my skin. It gave me new pimples, new marks, new blemishes. I thought this pimple is not gonna leave a mark because I used this on it. It still left a mark, so that's not cool. So if your skin is on the sensitive side, then I would definitely suggest that you do not purchase this, because it did this to my skin. Even though my skin is not particularly sensitive to anything, so I don't know what it's gonna do to you if you have sensitive skin. So. And those were all my likes and dislikes with this product. You can find this at Sephora for $9. I feel like for an acne product, this is a really good buy, because you get a lot of things with it. You get your reduction of pimples from it, which is primarily what it's supposed to do. You get a bit of color correction going on as well. You do get precision with this precision tip. So I do think that it is worth its price in that aspect. Would I recommend this to everybody? Absolutely, absolutely not. No way. Why? Because sensitive skin people might react badly to it. Number one. Number two, people look for a wholesome experience when it comes to acne treatment, not just the reduction of their pimples, but also reduction of their blemishes, which this cannot do. So if that's what you're looking for, then skip on it. Your acne will go in on its own. Your new breakouts will go away on their own. I hope, my prayers are with you, but if you think this is going to reduce your blemishes, it is not. So if you're okay with that fact, then go ahead and try it, because it will help your pimples, but blemishes, this has no effect on blemishes of any kind. Would I buy this again? No, because it did give me irritation, so I do not want any more of this, and I have kind of stopped using this. Like from today, I've stopped using it because it's giving me a lot of irritation. Sometimes I do feel itchy on these parts as well, so definitely I'm not going to purchase this at all. One of the reasons is also that it did not live up to its claims of reducing your blemishes or acne spots. Let's talk about my rating breakdown. First of all is performance. I'm gonna give it 0.5 points because even though it did reduce my pimples and made them go away, it did not help my blemishes at all, and it gave me a lot of irritation. Number two is price, and I'm gonna give it a 0.5 points because for an acne treatment, this is a really good price for it. For longevity and convenience, I'm gonna give it a 0.5 points because this does not take a lot of product for your pimples or your acne. So if you have a cluster of acne somewhere, a small dot is gonna be enough to cover all of those pimples. And then recommendation and repurchase, I'm gonna give it 0.5 points because this is not going to be suitable for every person, and it's not for me either. And then there is special features. I will give it 0.5 points because even though it does have a lot of good things about it, like its precision tip and all, I do not like that it did not live up to its claims of reducing your blemishes, as well as the fact that it can cause irritation in a lot of people. And trust me, there have been a lot of complaints with this product. If you don't believe me, go on to Sephora and look at the comments there, look at their reviews, and you will see for yourself. That brings my total Felicious score to a 3.5 out of a 5. This is slightly above average, which is what it is. Let's be honest here. It is good for your pimples, but is going to help the pimples not leave a mark? No. Is it going to help your blemishes? No. So it can only reduce your pimples and make sure they don't get more inflamed. If you've used this product before, then let me know in the comments what your thoughts are on that. And let me know what your favorite acne treatment is, how you like to deal with your acne or pimples or breakouts or whatever you want to call them. But that is it for me today. Thank you so much for watching and hanging out with me. Stay tuned for my next video where I'm going to review the L'Oreal Elvive Wonder Water Hair Transformation treatment. Or stick around and watch one of my older videos.